Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Rochelle from Rochelle Handmade Designs, where you could connect with me many different ways. Here are a few things that you could do in order to connect with me. First place is on Instagram at rochelle.handmadedesigns. You can also follow me on my Facebook page at rochelle.handmadedesigns. You can also connect with me here on YouTube. And you can also join one of our Facebook groups, well, where I will post here, 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 and here. So go ahead and follow me any kind of way that you would like and stay connected with me. Now in today's video, we will go ahead and talk about that first skirt as part of my summer skirt series. Now this skirt series is two parts. So the first part is sewing five skirts here in the month of May. So there are five skirts that will be sewn in May, and then the second part will be sewing another five additional skirts in the month of June. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into that first skirt as part of our summer skirt series. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about our first skirt in the skirt series, which is the flared skirt. So I am sewing along to Butterick 4686. It's also Butterick 6744. So if you have the new pattern, which is the same pieces, the same instruction, they just basically went ahead and reissue or re-release this pattern again. And this pattern new number is Butterick 6744. Now I do not have that pattern because I have this one, and I may go ahead and pick up 6744 at a later time, but I'm just gonna use the old pattern of Butterick 4686. Now I will be sewing along to view D with the length of view C on this pattern. So let's go ahead and talk about the supplies you will need in order to construct this flared skirt. So of course you will need the pattern. You will need rotary cutters. If you cut fabric with rotary cutter, you need one for paper, one for fabric. I never mix the two. I use scissors at the sewing machine sometimes. I use one for paper, one for fabric. I never mix the two there. I use thread clippers to clip my thread at the serger or sewing machine. So I use one of those. I also have my marking tool. This is a white pencil, my disappearing ink, some chalk, and then I have my seam ripper and my point turner. Seam ripper for if I make a mistake, I can easily rip it out. And the point turner is to poke out any sharp edges. I also have pins, and you're also going to need a 7-inch zipper. Now I am using an invisible zipper, but I believe the pattern calls for an exposed zipper, but I'm just going to use what I have in my stash already, and that's a 7-inch invisible zipper. Now that's all the supplies that you will need in order to construct this flared skirt. So let's go ahead and get right on into the pattern pieces. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about the pattern pieces that you will need. So I went ahead and pulled out the instructions, and according to the instructions to sew skirt view C, D, and E, you will need pattern piece 3, 4, 5, and 6. And that's just four pieces, and that's all you're going to need. So I'm gonna draw your attention to the skirt D. So there are no pieces that you need to have facing down. Now, pattern piece number 4 is cut on the fold, but if you look right here on the cutting layout, it wants you to do a single layer, and then you're gonna cut half of it and then flip it over on that fold. So that's why you need your chalk to make a line, fold it over, and then cut out the other side. So you're gonna do that for pattern piece number 4. Now, if you are using 45-inch fabric like I am, what I did is I just went ahead and cut on the fold because I had enough, more than enough fabric in order to cut it on the fold and still have some left to cut out the other pieces. So that's all the pattern pieces you're gonna need. So let's go ahead and talk about the pattern pieces so I can show you what are we doing with the pattern pieces. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the pattern pieces you will need in order to construct your first skirt as part of the skirt series, which is the flared skirt. So the first pattern piece you will need is pattern piece number 3, which is your skirt back. You need to cut to a fabric. The next pattern piece you will need is pattern piece number 4. And this is your skirt front. You need to cut one on fold of fabric. The next pattern piece you will need is pattern piece number 5, which is your yoke front. You need to cut one on the fold of fabric, but this piece needs to be face down on your fabric and then cut around. So this is the only piece that you need to have facing down on the fabric. And the last pattern piece you will need is pattern piece number 6, which is your yoke back. You need to cut 4 of these. And that's all the pieces you will need. So let's go ahead and get right on into the sewing. Now I do want to bring your attention to, I will be making one slight modification because I want pockets on my skirt. Now I just went ahead and drafted this pattern piece myself. So how I drafted that pattern piece is I just put my hand down, trace around all the way to my thumb, and then made a little line out. I want to say that line is probably about 1/4 of an inch, and then I just basically created a line from the top where my elbow is, or my wrist is, and then drew that down and across. And that's how I made my pattern piece. I just completely self-drafted this pattern piece, and I use this pattern piece for skirts that I make that's 25 inch or shorter. Anything longer than 25 inches, I use a bigger one to make it longer to where my pockets are not short. But you need to cut 4 of these if you decide to draft your own pattern, or you could go find a pattern from a different skirt that you like. You can do that as well. But you need to cut 4 of fabric. Now that's all the pieces that you will need. So let's go ahead and get right on into the sewing. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is grab pattern piece number 3, which is your skirt back. Now what you want to do is go ahead and finish off the center back seam. So basically it's this side where you have your notches. You want to go ahead and finish that off with your serger. And then once you do that with right sides together, you're going to pin at the bottom and all the way up to the dot. What you're going to do is using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, backstitch at the beginning, and then backstitch at this dot. Once you backstitch at that dot, you're gonna switch to a basting stitch and baste all the way up to the end of the top portion of your skirt. So go ahead and do that. Okay, so now that I have sewn the skirt back, which is pattern piece number 3, this is the skirt back, I went ahead and sewn them right sides together at 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, pressed my seams open, and what I did is applied interfacing to my zipper area where my zipper will be going. So now the next step that you want to do, now if you do not want to add pockets to your skirt, you will grab pattern piece number 4, which is the skirt front, and then with right sides together, you would attach pattern piece number 4 on both sides. So I'm gonna show you exactly what that looks like. So you would pin at the bottom all the way up to the very top of your skirt, making sure that you match up your notches, and then sewing 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, backstitch at the beginning and at the end, and then finish off your seam allowance. That's if you do not want to do the pockets, that's what you would do right now. But since I am adding pockets to my skirt, go ahead and grab your pocket pattern piece, whether you drafted your own like I did, or if you went ahead and just used a different pattern, that's completely up to you. So what you're going to do is with right sides together, you're gonna do this for both the front and the back. So this is my back pattern piece facing up. You're going to attach the pockets at the side seams. So I'm gonna attach there and right here as well. And using 3/8 of an inch seam allowance, you're gonna backstitch at the beginning and at the end, and then finish off the entire seam allowance. So go ahead and do that to both your front and your back pattern pieces. Okay, so now that I have my pockets attached to my front and my back, what you're going to do is with right sides together, so this is my skirt back with right sides up, facing up. This is my skirt front, so I'm gonna put that on top of my back, and I'm going to pin at the side seams, making sure that your seam for your pocket is pressed, the seam allowance is pressed towards the pocket. You're going to line up your seams and pin all the way down the length of your skirt. All right, so now that I have my my side seams pinned, so I'm going to backstitch at the beginning, come all the way down to the second pin, which is about 1 inch from the top I'm going to backstitch here at this pin, clip my threads, and then come down to this pin, backstitch right here at this pin right here, and then sew all the way down to the end of my side seam and then backstitch at the end. Once I do that, I'm gonna go ahead and sew around the pocket pieces. Now you're going to do this using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, backstitch at the beginning and at the end, and then once you're done stitching, you're going to finish off your seam allowance. Go ahead and do that. Okay, so now that I went ahead and sewn my side seam, I finished off my side seam, I finished off my pockets after sewing them together to the side of my skirt. So what the next thing you want to do and what you want to do is go ahead and pin your pockets towards the front of your skirt and then just baste across to keep that the pockets towards the front of your skirt. Once you do that, you are going to stay stitch or ease stitch all the way around using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. So go ahead and ease stitch or stay stitch, whatever you whichever one you want to call it. But I'm going to do mine at a 1/4 inch seam allowance all the way around. So go ahead and do that. Okay, so I did go ahead and ease stitch around the upper portion of my skirt. I ease stitched at about a 1/4 inch seam allowance, ease stitching between the center back seam. So basically I just sewn all the way around utilizing the center back as my start and stopping point. So go ahead and put your skirt to the side and grab your yoke front and back pieces, pattern piece 5 and 6. So your yoke front is pattern piece number 5, which was cut on the fold. You should have 2 of those and you should have 4 of your yoke back, which is pattern piece number 6. So with right sides together, you're going to pin at that notch and then pin at the top and the bottom. And using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, you're gonna backstitch at the beginning and at the end and press your seams open. You're going to do that for both yoke pieces. One yoke piece will be used as your facing piece. So go ahead and do that. Okay, so now that I have attached my yoke pieces together at the side seam, go ahead and grab your skirt, moving your yoke facing out of the way. And what you're going to do is make sure it is not the yoke piece. So basically one of the pieces would be your yoke facing. Move your yoke facing out of the way and you're going to grab one of your yoke pieces. Now with right sides together, you're going to pin around the upper portion of your skirt. So you want to pin the bottom portion. So basically where you have those double notches, so at the very bottom you have your double notches, you're going to pin that portion to your skirt. So basically it looks like your yoke pieces is making a frown. Now I'm going to match up those 2 notches to the 2 notches right here and pin. All right, so now that I have it pinned all the way around, what you're going to do is starting at the back. You're gonna backstitch at the beginning, so all the way around using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, backstitching at the beginning and at the end, and press your seams up towards the yoke. So go ahead and do that. Okay, so now that I went ahead and attached my yoke onto my skirt, and I pressed the seams up towards the yoke, the next thing you want to do is go ahead and pin your side seam. You're going to pin from the dot all the way up to the top. So what you're going to do is starting at the dot, you're using a basting stitch, you're gonna backstitch at the beginning and sew all the way up, basting 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. And then if you want, you can go ahead and attach some interfacing, fuse some interfacing along the top portion. Go ahead and do that, and then you're going to press your seams open. Okay, so I went ahead and attached my center back seam from the dot all the way up to the top. I pressed the seams open, and then I went ahead and finished off the top portion of my zipper area before I installed the zipper. Now, I'm using an invisible zipper, but you can use an exposed zipper. All you have to do is put it down right on the seam. Now I'm gonna turn mine to the side so you can see it. And I am just attaching the zipper to the seam allowance. Now there is a dot right here, so I'm going to put my zipper, the bottom portion of my zipper, about an eighth of an inch below it. And then I'm just going to pin on the seam allowance. All right, so now that I have it pinned, I'm gonna go to the sewing machine and using a basting stitch, I'm just going to sew just on the seam allowance. So I'm gonna move my skirt out of my way and just sew on the seam allowance. I'm just gonna baste it down on both sides. So I'm gonna baste going down and then I'm gonna flip it over and then sew from the bottom up. So go ahead and do that. All right, so now that I have my zipper basted on, what I'm going to do is turn it right side out. And I'm going to open up that seam allowance that I basted it closed in order to finish off my zipper. So I'm just going to open it up from this dot right here all the way up. All right, so now that I have my zipper basted on, I'm going to go ahead and using a regular length stitch, I'm going to sew as close to the zipper teeth, opening out my coals to sew as close as possible in order to finish off my zipper. And then I'm gonna go ahead and prepare my facing. So go ahead and do that. All right, so now that I have finished off my zipper, everything looks good with my zipper. I tried it on, it fits. Everything's looking good. So go ahead and put your skirt aside for a second and grab your facing piece. So on the facing piece, what you want to do is at the bottom lower edge, you want to create a 5/8 of an inch basting stitch, press up that seam allowance, and then you're going to trim it down to 3/8 of an inch seam allowance. So go ahead and trim your facing down to 3/8 of an inch seam allowance. All right, so now that I have it trimmed down to 3/8 of an inch seam allowance, go ahead and grab your skirt and make sure that you open out your zipper, whether you used an invisible zipper or a exposed zipper, which was completely up to you. It's a personal preference. So you want to open out your zipper and you're going to attach your facing to your skirt. Now make sure that you open out your zipper, you don't have it folded onto itself, and you're just going to pin all the way around, matching up the notches and the side seam. All right, so now that I have it pinned all the way around, you're going to backstitch at the beginning, so all the way around and backstitch at the end. Sewing 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. Go ahead and do that and press your seams up towards your yoke facing. Okay, so I went ahead and sewn my facing onto my yoke. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and trim the seam allowance down and clip off that extended zipper right here as well. So go ahead and do that if you have not already. And then press your seam allowance towards your yoke. So go ahead and do that. All right, so now that I have my seam allowance trimmed, what I'm gonna do is press my seam allowance down towards the facing. I'm gonna press my seam allowance up towards the yoke facing, which is this piece right here. So let me turn my skirt around. So what I'm going to do is press the seam allowance up towards the facing and then understitch on the facing. This is the facing piece and you want to understitch on your facing. So go ahead and do that now. All right, so I went ahead and understitched on my facing. So the next thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and turn down the zip. I'm gonna go ahead and finish off the zipper teeth area. So what you're going to do is go ahead and turn the facing onto itself. And I wanna finish that off. And you're going to pin close to the teeth. And I'm just gonna pin up the zipper teeth. And now what you're gonna do is go to the sewing machine and use your zipper foot, your invisible zipper foot, whatever, or you could use your regular foot as well. And you want to sew close to the teeth, but not on the zipper teeth. So go ahead and finish off your zipper area doing that. And then you want to trim the corner. So clip into your corner, but do not clip through your stitching. You're gonna do that on both sides. So go ahead and do that. And the only thing that's left for you to do is go ahead and do your hem, and then you're going to go ahead and attach your facing. But before you do that, go ahead and finish off your zipper teeth, your zipper area, and then go ahead and sew up your hem. Your hem is 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, so you're just going to sew your hem in place as well. And once you do that, we'll go ahead and finish off the yoke. So go ahead and do that. All right, so I went ahead and finished off my zipper area, basically turning it onto itself and sewing close to the edge. I turn it right side out and gave it a nice press. So the only thing left to do is go ahead and you have two options. So let me go ahead and open out my zipper. You have two options. You could slip stitch, basically that press edge. You're going to bring it about 1/8 of an inch over that seam line. What you can do is you could slip stitch by using a hand needle and attach it all the way around, or you could do what I'm going to do and stitch in the ditch. That's basically stitching in this ditch on the right side, catching that pressed edge. So you could do either one that you choose. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and stitch in the ditch along the top part of mine. That's how I'm gonna finish off mine. And then the only thing you have to do is sew your hem. So you're gonna press up 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. Now me, it's a personal preference. I'm gonna press up 1 inch hem allowance. So I'm gonna create a 1 inch basting stitch, press to that line, and then press up again that 1 inch. And then on the right side, I'm going to sew my hem down. Once you do that, you are all done with your flare skirt. So there you have it. You just finished sewing your first skirt as part of our summer skirt series. So like, comment, and subscribe, and also turn on the notification bell so you are notified every time I upload a new video. So as always, until next time, keep sewing.